Hi, welcome back to the Robonaut 2 lab. Just recently in orbit, we saw the astronauts working with Robonaut on the first work that it was going to accomplish in orbit. But meanwhile, here on the ground, the engineers have been working on some spin-offs from the technology they used to invent Robonaut. And here we have with us talking about that today, the GM lead engineer for the Robo-Glove project, Chris Erke. Thanks for talking with us, Chris.
Sure.
So, okay, we already talked with Lyndon a little bit about what this glove actually does, but tell us a little bit about how GM is involved.
Well, GM and NASA are partnered together on a variety of robotic projects because we share the common interest of finding ways that technology can assist humans.
Okay, and so why is that important for automotive industry? What's the connection there?
The case of the human grasp assist device here, we are looking for applications in the automotive industry where ergonomic stressors, repetitive motion injuries, or the risk of those types of injuries can both be hazardous to our people and drive inefficiencies in our process.
Okay, so for NASA, we talked about how we were looking at spacewalk uses. They get their hands get tired when they're on spacewalks because they're using them so much and having to work against the spacesuit glove. I guess it's kind of the same thing for y'all. You're doing the same task over and over, and it takes a lot of strength?
Yes. There's a wide range of tasks in automotive assembly. Some of them require a firm grasp on a trigger type device or lifting a heavy object, or some require strong pinch force for snapping plastic parts together, for example, or holding tools firmly that may be vibrating while you're working. So any of these are possible applications where an assistive technology would help reduce the risk of injury for the user.
Okay, so I guess y'all have good reason to be excited about this glove too.
Yep.
All right, well, has the partnership in general been a good thing for y'all?
Absolutely. There are, in addition to the robot, this is just one of several spin-offs from the technology within the robot that we're hoping to find more short-term uses for in manufacturing.
Mm-hmm. What do you think it is about the Robonaut 2 system that's so useful for so many things?
Well, the robot's dexterity is outstanding, and so there's a much wider range of possibilities for the use of a Robonaut-type system in manufacturing than what we currently can find today with traditional robots.
Okay, so we might expect to see some more uses come out of it, huh?
Yes.
All right, well, hopefully we'll talk to you again then.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you.